Hello, children. Hello, children. Hello, children. It's nice to see you here. Hello, children. Hello, children. Hello, children. It's nice to see you here. Hi, guys. Happy Sunday. Hey, guess what? We are going to see each other today. A lot of us, hopefully, will get to see each other because we're going to meet at the farm and have church in person today. It's going to be awesome. Miss Chrissy, I just wanted to do a video to keep everybody kind of on track so you can know we're on lesson 4 today and make sure everybody knows where to find all the resources that they need to go over the lesson. Because when we meet in person, we're not going to do Sunday school and we're not going to have a little kid's lesson like this. So you guys can do it. Maybe you and your mommies and daddies or grown-ups will do it later today on Sunday or do it some other day during the week. But just so you know which lesson we're on, and for people that like, hey, maybe you can't come, it's too hot, or you have somebody's sick in your family and you can't come today, you can still watch a little bit of the lesson and then go watch your Bible story with Miss BA. Yeah, this week there's, you know, just like there has been, the parent page is actually really sweet and really encouraging for all the parents out there, for the mommies and daddies and grown-ups. And then for you guys, kids, there's a really cool coloring page. Today, our lesson is about how Abraham and Sarah, God fulfilled his promise to them in their very old age and gave them a baby Isaac. And that's what our story is about today. So there's a picture of the coloring page. See, it's Abraham and Sarah and baby Isaac. How God kept his promise to them with baby Isaac. And yeah, and then there's another page too, like normal, about things you can do to reinforce the lesson, either the day you see it or maybe another day during the week. So yep, if you see in the video, just like before, underneath Miss Chrissy's YouTube video in the description, if you click on Show More, you should see all the links to Miss BA's Bible story and the parent page and then the coloring and the to-do page. Just wanted to remind everybody of that. And our lesson from God's True Word today that Miss BA is going to go over is in your Bible. It's in Genesis 12 and 18 and 21 and all different places between Genesis 12 and 21. So that's where you can go if you want to get your Bible and get it ready for your story with Miss BA. Okay, let's pray. I have a question for you and then you can go do your Bible story. Okay. Open, shut them, give a little clap, clap, clap. Open, shut them, lay them in your lap. Our hands we fold, our heads we bow, so we can talk to God just now. God, thanks so much for this lesson where we learn that baby Isaac was born to Abraham and Sarah, and there's nothing too hard for you. Thank you for their faith. And you, God, I pray that we can have faith like that for all of these kids and for all of us to have faith in you and trust you that you will keep your promises because you do. Thank you, God, for being so faithful. We pray in your name. Amen. Okay, so I have a question for you. How many of you have a baby brother or sister? Well, maybe not right now, but how many of you have ever had a baby brother or sister? Or how many of you have been around somebody who has a baby brother or sister, right? It's so fun to have babies around. They're so cute. They're kind of gross too, and they poop a lot, and they burp, and they cry, but they're really, really cute, right? As Emmy, my little Emmy, she's 2, she would say, oh, they're so cute, right? This is one of our little baby dolls. I thought I would hold a little baby and show you, because our story today is about how Abraham and Sarah, they were very, very old. Now, guess what? Okay. How many of you have a grandma and grandpa? Or somebody in your life that's really old, that's like a grandma and grandpa? Yeah, I bet all of you do. And so Abraham and Sarah in our story today were very old. They were older even than your grandmas and grandpas, I'm sure. I'm pretty sure that's accurate. But they were very, very old. And they were waiting for a long time for God to fulfill his promise that they would have a baby, that they would have someone to carry on their family, and that God would keep his promise to bless all people through their family, because they didn't have Abraham and Sarah didn't have a son or a daughter of their own. So God promised them that they would have a son and that they should name him Isaac, and they did have a son and they named him Isaac. So God kept his promise to them, and guess what? Isaac, the name Isaac means laughter. And I want you to remember that and think about it when you hear the story. Why would it be important that the name Isaac means laughter. Some of you probably know the answer to that already, but it's kind of cool to pay attention to that. I want to read something for the mommies and daddies real quick to close us. But guys, kids, I want you to think about, I think this is so neat. The last couple lessons that we have had, there's been so many cool things about like nature, right? Rainbows and the stars in the sky that can remind us of God's promises and how he keeps his promises and how he is faithful and true. And we can see those things and think those things about God. But guess what? All of our stories, a lot of our stories have had babies or children in them, right? Our first one was about Cain and Abel and then baby Seth who came along. And now this one, this story is about baby Isaac and how he was a fulfillment of God's promise to Abraham and Sarah. And I just think it's really neat, guys, because kids are so important to God. You guys are so important to him. He has big plans for you and a great purpose for your life. And just because you're not a grown-up doesn't mean you are not super special and important. God, Jesus loved having little kids around him, and God loves kids. He's using kids in all these stories to show how his promises are true. And I think that's really neat. You should feel really important, and you can praise God for that as kids. Okay, I want to read something from the parent page for all the mommies and daddies. So maybe all these words might not make sense to you kids, but I think this is really encouraging. It encouraged Miss Chrissy a lot. Okay, this is from the parent page, kind of a summary of what the lesson's about and what we're trying to teach the kiddos in the story, right? So it says, Isaac, baby Isaac, right, that we're going to talk about. This isn't baby Isaac, but baby Isaac came just at the right time in God's unfolding covenant plan for his people. Sarah miraculously carried the first son in a line of promise that ultimately culminated with the birth of the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior from sin. We can be sure that just as God was unfailingly faithful to Abraham, Sarah, and Isaac, so he is to each of us. God tells us that nothing's too hard for him, so we can count on him to fulfill every one of his promises. Praise God for his goodness to his people. And I just thought that was really encouraging to me. I'm thankful for God's goodness to us, and I know you guys probably are too. So have fun learning about Abraham and Sarah and baby Isaac. And yeah, I'll see you on YouTube like this again next week with lesson 5. So, all right, guys, have a great day. Bye.